no violence, no violence, it doesn't matter. And whenever it comes around the top, we'll cross your arms. Go through. Okay. Oh, yeah, I love you so. When we come around the top.
A little hard.
Okay, man. If I get into a squat, same thing. You're on your feet this time, it's gonna be easier. A little hop on it.
You know, if you were really third graders, it'd be easier. Yeah, you wouldn't waste
it. Try to do a single jump too.
Here we go.
Keep the jumping going. Now, once you get a couple in, let's go the other way. Let's do it. Good. Put one leg, put one foot behind the other knee. Now, between jumps, try to switch legs.
Your rope on your teacher's arm. Go.
Okay.
Bring it in.
Everybody bring me a jump rope.
partner out, and when I blow my whistle, I'll need you to find a partner. Start moving.
Way back here.
Always keeping her in the face. Always, well,
it's a plastic ball.
Still, I don't
want to
get hit in the face.
Try to
get the ball
in
as quick as you can. So,
look at the student
behind her.
What's that?
Look at the student behind her. You don't want to give her up.
You try to play first before they get there. First base before they get there, and then if they're already there, try to throw it home and get them out.
It's scary, huh? Oh, it means it's a high scoring game, which means it's
fun.
Okay, so she finally caught her. She went to the closet.
Hey, what's the play catcher?
Think of the lesson.
Think
of it as the whole of it in student management, safety, and discipline. And take communication, and then teach and think instruction. Try in your head to figure out what you want to say about the first lesson. Positive.
Hi, guys.
Positive.
Yeah.
controlling the game.
And she can't see her batters. Because they're in her peripheral vision and they all have to look
through. She was out of it. Mm-hmm. But you can see her RS and you can see every other.
So I know her back to the last batter.
And you got too much going on to keep up with.
Yes.
But she's got a little voice. So
she's not firing with them. She's acting like their friend.
She's acting like their friend.
More than their coach.
They're having fun though. So they're really having a good time.
She's keeping their energy up. And she's not correcting, but she is giving positive feedback.
How many of the, who is using their actual names? Did you hear Joseph use her name? I've heard Joseph use
the only name she has used is Trey's name.
So you talk to her, so she uses her name, she won't call her you. Right? And that's something I'm never scared to work on. Don't make me drunk on the lesson. Right, be steady with your camera. Move it very slowly. Otherwise, when you stop working, they'll say, Miss Lavergne can't hold the camera. I'm a subservient to you. I'm not in charge. Please don't get mad at me. And I'm not picking on her.
It's just you gotta play the money more. You gotta prepare her for actual teaching. And you're gonna do it to all of us.
I'm gonna do it to all. And you'll all work it out. Yeah, the lessons at the end of the semester are 100 times better than the ones at the beginning. That noise just freaks you out.
And you know it's coming, too.
Well, real third graders don't get quite this hard, but it is noisy. You don't have... She's a softball player. She's good. Oh, he got it. He's a softball. You're a soccer player. She's a softball player. She can handle you. No, Kevin. Her to be able to sit and work afterwards.
I would have had
so
that if you were making it.
Right. So.
Alright. Drop the ball.
Yeah.
close to switching. I'm just going to let it roll and run out of time with that doing it. I'm not going to save them anymore.
Oh, no. Good catch.
Well, it was her watch. Maybe she's got a phone somewhere. Yeah, she has a watch on. It's just so good. Play this with three bases. You could play it with no way to strike out, you know, to get it as hard to hit it. Just depends on the skill of all your kids. You can move the base closer and they can keep scoring as many runs as they think they can until somebody comes in. It's really called confusion. There's all kinds of ways to do it. And also, we're not playing with our milk jugs as our catch. That makes it harder to catch it with a milk jug. I'm just a softball player, and I don't think I can do it. Challenging.
She was super nervous about it, so I know she was on top of herself.
Should have
been. See, because she's sat on the wall.
Yeah. you're going to keep warning people and warning people, and you have no credibility with the entire class, and then everybody will start being bad. That will make the kids really not good if you keep them busy and they're having fun, and you don't give them much trouble.
But I find when they do and they've gotten away with it, they're mouthier.
Oh, yeah, high school. Oh, it's true.
Because I help with the fifth grade class. The sixth grade class. I have one kid in there who came from a bad home that everybody acknowledges. Oh, she's okay. I'm like, no, you don't talk to me like that. You know, I don't get paid right now, so I don't have to put up with it. You go, and I've made her sit out.
It is very important that kids learn to respect authority. If they do not learn to respect authority, it's elementary. But often they get in trouble every time they go to school. If you can't come to school, you have no time. So you do learn to favor, but you can't respect yourself. The social skills is part of PE. Teaching the social skills is extremely important.
I need you to bounce it on the tip of your toe, and then you're going to try to bring out to your
finger. What skill are we practicing these feathers?
Balance and mind.
Right.
Because a lot of it has to do with the mind control over, like a mind over matter thing.
Make sure you have a steady hand.
And they don't have great locomotive skills or balance skills.
And it's not difficult for the kids who don't like PE can't do it. So it gives them an out to
everything has to be competitive.
Yes.
In fact, the little kids, they really don't like competition. You don't start loving competition until you get to like middle school age about.
Yeah, it's different, but I grew up in a family that did it.
Yeah, it was their values got pushed on it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at normal kids, they don't worry about if they are messing up or not messing up until adults make them feel bad about messing up. Then they I want to see you take it from your foot to your hand without messing up. Like, toss it up. Toss it up to your hand. Can you get them to pick up their equipment?
All right, or, guys, let's bring it in. I need you to bring me your feathers. Good job today.
Sorry.
You've got to...